So, Pax Rubiana, this time, you know, civilization starts. Here's the highway from Elbasan to Tirana. This is amazing. This is the future. This is really cool. This is how it should be. And this is where really you feel good and, you know, the prosperity starts, the connectivity. This is excellent, yeah? Now the next 45 kilometers on a beautiful highway, amazing tunnel. The road is open towards Europe here on this beautiful highway. It's not the perfect, you know, Kosovo-style highway from Bechtel, but it's, you know, two lanes in both directions with a little bit of security, and it is a very nice tunnel. I will show you this one, and this is how the future should be. And I cannot understand why Albania and Macedonia have not the same. It's only these 60 kilometers, yeah, until Ohrid, and then obviously also Macedonia should do it for its part. But this is very important. This is civilization, this is progress, prosperity, this is cool, this is road security, road safety, this is less accidents, yeah? This is more time for other things, yeah. It was the most terrible road up there in the mountains in the past. I will never forget it, how complicated mountain climbing it was and how dangerous the road up there was, and it's still there. If you want, you can see. And then obviously, you know, then it lifts people out of the poverty. You see, this is the poverty of the past. And then you will see there is a lot of investment now coming because of the highway. The highway is the artery of prosperity. This is what we need. We need a very good highway everywhere in the Balkans. And it was promised in 2014 and it was not delivered. And that's my complaint here. No, you see, all these mineral resources of Albania, they can then be transported, they can be developed. The energy resources, you need the infrastructure. And the infrastructure is absolutely vital. And then people can trade, they can construct, they can build, they can develop, and economic prosperity starts from that. And you see, there's a lot of material, there's good people, there's productive entrepreneurship. Obviously, it would help to have the euro as well, that's also a big difference. But the whole potential of the Balkans will be lifted with the right infrastructure, and this is not only to be paid by the taxpayers of Albania because it's a bit too poor. It's European-style infrastructure. That's why we have a union. That's why we have a continental union. And all the potential will be up. So that's why America is a continental Europe. That's why we are a continental Europe. And we need to get this done. And that's so important. And it makes such a difference if you drive on such a highway or you drive on... the Kosovo highways are still much better, no doubt. But nevertheless, this is the real movement. Good. And this is the way it should be. And I call now the European Union to make a more effort and the real efforts, not only talking about budgets and billions, but really push all governments to work together decently and to have the infrastructure on the highways done. And that's the priority. The railways really can wait. We need the highways first, and the highways must be connected. All regional capitals must be connected with decent highways. Then we can do other things as well, which are also important, but it's first of all the highways which really matters, and this is a stage of economic development. And look, suddenly we can drive much faster, everything looks much brighter, even when the rain is of course not the same like in the sun, but driving is safety as well then when the rain is there, because you have space, you have security, and you have a certain transport speed. That's the whole thing. And that's why I called for highways, and that's very important. So please, I think I was very clear this message. This is civilization, this is progress. If the Austrians don't want to do it anymore, then let's build it here, and let's build very beautiful highways here. That's a good investment for European taxpayers' money. Let's do it continent-wide, paid by the European taxpayers, and to make sure that we have this kind of standard and not that kind of standard. That's the old road. Here's the new road, and that's good. That's then the road, the mountains towards Albania, so towards Tirana. We will be there in whatever, I think 50 kilometers on a highway is just less than 20 minutes, and that's of course really good. Here's one of the highway exits. You see also the Elbasan Tirana 400 kV energy highway. it's also connected and things are moving towards European level from Elbasan onwards. Yeah? That what I showed you before, this was the old Albania of the past. Here now the modern Albania is starting. And of course this amazing, beautiful capital of Tirana. I've showed you in the summer already Tirana and tourists. I hope that next year I can show you a lot about the south of Albania and the north. I hope that is also possible. But first of all, now obviously it's important to see this amazing progress of Elbasan-Tirana highway infrastructure, and hopefully there will be wisdom to build also Corridor 8, not only on the drawing board in Brussels and Berlin, but in the real life and real concrete. Life is concrete, yeah. As I always say, peace is also concrete. We need to be concrete and then things work. And then suddenly things are really very useful and they are good, yeah? Because we basically have then progress and people don't have to emigrate because they can build up their companies, they can trade, the tourists can come, the trade can flow towards cross-country, and then we build the customs union, we adopt the euro. It's not so complicated and then suddenly everything is European. And then not everybody has to leave, but more people will want to come. Because there's prosperity and nothing is as successful and magnetic as prosperity. And then suddenly things are beautiful, safe. And that's the difference. That's the beauty of having European style infrastructure. And that's what I call for. Over there you will see now, I think very soon we will have the tunnel. And that's amazing. That is one of the biggest tunnels in the Balkans. That's the two major infrastructure projects I've shown you already. The infrastructure, the tunnel towards Kosovo, the longest, and that's the second longest. Yeah. It was built by a Greek company, and here's the entrance. And that's of course amazing. And that makes all the difference in prosperity and in life quality, in speed. 20 minutes from Tirana to Elbasan. That's cool. It was a 1 hour ride if you were lucky and you were always sweating to be alive. And now you just in some seconds, in 7 minutes now we're on the highway and then we are in this tunnel. And that's cool. I mean, that's amazing. That's Europe. And that's amazing. I cannot. That's how we should do it. And the same could be done already if there would be some leadership. Rama could have done the same tunnel to Macedonia, then he is serious. But no,